إننا لن نقبل باستمرار الوضع الراهن في فلسطين المحتلة.
Palestinian President Mahmoud Abbas released a pre-recorded speech to the Palestinian public Wednesday night, in which he mostly repeated statements from past speeches. Abbas chose not to call for de-escalation of violence. Rather, he continued with his ongoing incitement. Israeli officials tore into Abbas's claims that Israel executed a 13-year-old Palestinian boy, Ahmed Mansara, noting that the child was not dead. Netanyahu's main opposition party in the Knesset, the Zionist Union, called Abbas's claim grave defamatory statements that distort reality, border on utter responsibility, and only serve to further fan the flames of hopelessness and hatred in the region. Abbas did not attempt to calm the burning tensions during his speech. Instead, he chose to lie to the world and Palestinians by claiming that Israel is attempting to change the status quo on the Temple Mount, the very same claim that sparked the clashes. Abbas also emphasized that the Palestinians would not surrender to the Israeli aggression against the Palestinian people, their holy places, homes, and the execution of children like Ahmed Mansara, referring to the 13-year-old who conducted a stabbing attack in Pisgat Ze'ev. Abbas, who waved a picture of the young terrorist lying on the road, failed to mention that Mansara is in fact currently alive and receiving treatment in an Israeli hospital. The terrorist's father told Channel 2 News that there is no way his boy could have stabbed the Israeli. My son cannot stab. He doesn't know how to hold a knife. On Wednesday, Israeli police released video of the attack and that his son is very proficient with holding a knife, even more so in stabbing innocent people. In the video, the two terrorists are seen walking down the street and moments later they each hold a knife while chasing a 21-year-old Jew they allegedly stabbed off camera. He manages to get away, but the two knife-wielding Palestinians don't leave the area. The video then shows a 13-year-old Jewish boy as he makes his way out of the convenience store. You can clearly see his bike tip over, as the Jewish boy is reportedly stabbed. Moments later, the two run down the street. One of them is hit by oncoming traffic, while 13-year-old Mansard is surrounded by police. Instead of dropping the knife and surrendering, he makes his way towards the two armed officers, who neutralize him. An ambulance takes him to Hadassah Hospital, where his life was saved by Israeli doctors. The 13-year-old Jewish boy Mansara and his cousin stabbed is still in a coma. In another Palestinian terror attack, a man smashes his car into a bus station. He proceeds to come out and kill people with an axe. A nearby security guard arrives at the scene and neutralizes the terrorist. In the last 3 weeks, 7 Israeli citizens have been killed and over 100 injured. Palestinians continue to clash with Israeli forces in the West Bank and East Jerusalem. The Palestinian leadership and terrorist groups continue to incite young Palestinians on social media and disseminate lies. It is these lies by Palestinian officials and the Palestinian president that are the major cause of the ongoing bloodshed.
A real sense of panic has taken hold here in Jerusalem and in other Israeli cities too.
And the mainstream media isn't helping promote the truth. While covering the rise in violence in the Middle East, Canada's national publicly funded broadcaster, the CBC, has been doing its best to minimize the daily terrorist attacks that Israelis have been experiencing. A simple visit to the site will reveal the way that the CBC presents Israel as the aggressor and the Palestinians as the victims. In most of the reports found online, the CBC simply chose to present no videos or photos of any attacks on Israelis by Palestinians, minimizing the horrific daily attacks that Israelis endure. Instead, the editors of the CBC have mainly chosen videos and photos that show Israeli forces confronting Palestinian protesters. All of the various videos we've shown in the past few weeks are available to the CBC. Yet it seems that the CBC has chosen to whitewash Israeli suffering as to not interfere with the ongoing anti-Israel narrative that they have been feeding to Canadians for many years. This comes as no surprise to honestreporting.com, an organization that monitors the Canadian media and the way it covers the Middle East. Very recently, Honest Reporting came out with a damning report against CBC's chief Middle East bureau, Margaret Evans. The report claims that Evans has been whitewashing and excusing Palestinian terror. In this recent report from Jerusalem, Evans says that
there's a lot of unhappiness amongst Palestinians over the way in which the Israeli government or Israeli security forces have responded. They say that they shouldn't be so heavy-handed in some of these attacks, that they should be able to disarm the knife-wielding attackers rather than to just shoot them down.
Evans, who controls the flow of information from the Middle East to many Canadian homes, is really accusing Israel of a disproportionate response. According to Honest Reporting, even more so, she refuses to show the violent attacks that Israeli police must deal with. Yet it seems that the editorial staff is always eager to show clashes between Israeli police and Arab youth. In the report, Evans forgets to mention to Canadian viewers that the majority of the terrorists were not killed and are neutralized in the same manner that is used by Canadian and American police. If shot, the terrorists are taken to Israeli hospitals, and in some cases are even treated before the victims. It seems that the CBC, funded by Canadian taxpayers, continues to misinform and mislead Canadians about what is really happening in the Middle East. For the Rebel.media, I'm Miguel Hecht.
Ow! We're building a studio. Help us out. Click here or visit buildthedream.ca.